97.7 DJX, the Ben Davis and Kelly K Show podcast.
Supplying every demand.
On demand.
First off, I'll give the phone number out real quick. 502-571-9970 if you want to chime in on this. We got a message from a listener, and if you've got an issue, maybe it's with a relationship, or maybe you just want a third, fourth, fifth opinion, we'll toss it out to our listeners and see what we can do for you. She says, hey guys, I have a dilemma at our house. My husband and I were talking with my brother who lives in the area. He's single, very successful, and has a great paying job. Let's just say money isn't an issue for him. Like, he gets a brand new car every few years and has sometimes given an old, and she put that in quotes, one to a family member. My guess is the car is valued anywhere from like $70,000 to $80,000.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's not a cheap car.
No.
That's not a typical car price.
Well, my husband said if we got the car, he'd sell it because we don't need to be driving around in an expensive car. But I know this would really upset my brother. And frankly, I really would love driving it because splurging isn't something we typically do.
Girl.
My husband.
She should keep it. Just at this point, I feel like I'm on deep keep the car.
Yeah, my husband is a wonderful man, but he's also prideful and modest. I think we should take my brother up on the offer, but how do I convince my husband of getting the car and keeping it? Or do we just take it and sell it? Or should we just tell my brother, thanks but no thanks, and risk, you know, hurting his feelings?
Yeah, that's a, well.
That's a, wow. Okay, so, like, I do have experience with, like, one-upping siblings on, like, gifts. And I remember one year for Christmas, like, I gave my mom a leather chair, like, that she had been wanting. And my sister, at the time, she had spent all this time making, like, wind chimes herself. And the leather chair got completely outshadowed her wind chimes that she had made my mom. And so there was a little bit of like friction there between my sister and myself there. Uh-oh. For a little bit. But like, this is completely different.
Well, yes. And okay, so your husband, let's pretend that your wife's brother
mm-hmm.
gave you super fancy car. What are you doing with it?
Okay, so my practical, like, initial thought is, how much is the insurance? And, you know, what gas does it take? Basically, like, okay. what's the upkeep going to be on this gift?
Well, but it's going to probably be less than an actual car payment would be. And you don't have the car payment.
I mean, this is true. But then the other side of me is like, oh, man, like, depending on what kind of car it is, that would be really cool to drive.
Uh-huh.
So...
And then, like, what kind of thank you do you give them?
I think we're getting away from, like, what the original question is. So, if you've got an opinion of how she should approach this with her husband and her brother, because there's two guys here that she's going to have to deal with this issue, feel free to chime in at Ben and Kelly Show or 502-571-9970. Ben Davis, Kelly K Show. Got an interesting message from a listener whose brother gives really great gifts. Like, he's in a spot financially where when he buys a car, he turns around and gives his slightly used car to family members. And her husband's all like, you know what? He's prideful and modest and is like, I don't want the car. I don't want his charity or whatever. And so she's all like, but they're really nice cars.
And it's a really generous gift. And it's her brother.
Yeah.
And I kind of feel like, you know, accept it and appreciate the fact you have such a generous family.
Yeah. So what to do? You know, Samantha texts in and says, don't take away someone's blessing. If he has the means to do that, then let him. And I would not sell it right away because I think that would hurt his feelings more than not taking it. You know what? That's a good point.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. I think everybody agrees that if you're going to accept the car, mm-hmm. do not sell it. Mm-hmm. That's the biggest slap in the face. Mm-hmm. Now, if you feel like you can't, then you can just say, thank you, but no thank you. Mike suggested giving it to someone that, you know, needs it more than they do. Sandra, though, said, if you can afford the maintenance, then keep mm-hmm. it. It's a gift. Sell your current car. You can accept it as a gift to you from your brother. Your husband doesn't have to drive it. He shouldn't begrudge you of something only because he doesn't want it himself. Oh, there you go. This is mama's wagon.
Yeah. All right. You continue to drive the minivan, how about? And I'll drive this, right? I mean, you know, if I had the means, I think cars would be something that I would like to buy, you know, where, you know, I'd like to drive around a nice car, you know, and because I, for years, have always driven my cars to the ground, driven them to
forever.
Death. Yes, exactly. Yeah. So, like, to have a sibling who has the means to do that, I think might be kind of fun. Now, however, I'm not in that situation, and I'm not like the husband where he's obviously, he feels offended that the brother would just assume that they would want his, quote, hand-me-downs of luxury.
I would want it.
Yeah.
I mean, here's the thing. Would you accept it, Ben? Would you accept it?
Well, here, before I give my answer, I want to jump over to Jennifer, calling from Seymour. Hey, Jennifer, what's your question?
Hey, so have we figured out whether or not this vehicle is practical for them to drive?
I didn't ask. I should have.
Because that's the first question that you gotta, I mean, is it a Cadillac Escalade and they only have one person in the house, you know?
Right.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if it's not practical, then she should just say, hey, brother, I love you, but this isn't practical for us.
Mm-hmm.
Give it to somebody else.
But man, what if it's just a nice car?
Well, you know, my sister is in that financial position.
Yeah.
And she has done that. Every time she goes to get a new car, she does the same thing. She buys it outright. She
right.
doesn't have a, she never does a car payment. So, you know, for us, sometimes it's not practical.
Okay.
You know, it's a two-door sports car, and I've got kids.
And your sister's cool with it. If you're like, hey, you know what? Thank you. Get the next one, but maybe not this time.
She's absolutely cool with it. She, you know, she
all right.
puts it out there and says, okay, you know, I'm getting a new car. I've got this one. Who wants it?
Oh, that's awesome.
And you know, we're like, nah, thanks, but no thanks.
I appreciate the phone call,
okay,
Jennifer.
That would make sense. Like, if it was a sedan, like a really fancy luxury sedan, and they've got like a lot of kids,
yeah.
it would make sense.
But
you know, that could be, you know, an easy way to turn them down without them being offended.
But still, that could be your weekend car.
That could be your fun car.
I don't know, you know, I don't know.
That could be your car like my parents have. They've got a Corvette. Never sees a drop of rain.
Yeah.
Never sees, you know, any sort of bad weather. They take it out for pizza on the weekend.
All right, so let's kind of tie this up. Yeah, like, we've got a lot of great suggestions on how to approach this with the brother and the husband. So what are we saying here?
Well, hands down, we do not accept the car if you were thinking, I'm going to turn around and sell it. That's the biggest slap in the face. You can't do that.
Okay.
So the next thing is, if it's practical, if it would fit your family, accept it. If not, say, you know what, thank you so much. We really appreciate your generosity. It just isn't practical for us.
So just try to get the husband on board.
Yes. There's a couple of things that we don't have answers to.
Yeah. All right.
But if it's this, go door A. If it's this, go door B.
Or door
C. There's ways to handle it without offending the brother.
Or door C, give the brother my phone number.
There you go. Oh, we would really like to step in. And
we could.
Ben Davis could use another car.
I mean, I'm just throwing it out there.
People talk real nice about you on the radio.
Right. All right. So I get that you probably didn't have an opportunity to call in. You can always leave your comment at Ben and Kelly Show on Facebook.
I mean, yeah? They need to see a picture of the single wealthy brother who's handing out cars.
They're like, you know what? Here's the thing. You know, I could help.
Yeah, Elizabeth's like, I'm also single. Would love to meet your brother. He doesn't even have to give me the car.
That is funny. It's funny you say that because we got a tweet just from Christina who's like, he's single, right? I'm totally happy to step in and accept some of these gifts. Bro would be happy. Someone appreciates him. And hubby will be happy too. Win-win.
So many helpers.
I love that about our listeners.
Podcast. Can't get enough. Come back tomorrow for a brand new episode. Only on 99.7 DJX.